Hello people! Today I will show you how to create this abstract frame modern background with Inkscape. So let's get started. Okay, this time I play with this small canvas. Make sure you active this Mac Pick Studio Border and click this rectangle tool. And go to this corner, you see this tooltip, and drag it down to this corner. Okay, let's select this gradient tool. Make sure this square in selection. Go to this gradient and drag it down. So this is the color we want to use for the gradient, the yellow and the red. Here's the color code you can input in the fill and stroke menu to this box. Alright, so for the top, double click this and press D on your keyboard for the dropper tool. And click it, and for the bottom, double click this with this dropper tool mode, click this red. Alright, this is for the background, make sure it locks. Go to the layer and click this lock icon. If the icon is locked, it means the layer is locked and you can disrupt this layer. Double click, name it into Biggie, and let's create the new layer above the current and name it into Object. Okay, in this object layer, go to this turtle and drag it by holding Ctrl Shift. Okay, make sure the corner is 6 and change it into this polygon, so it will like this. Let's change this red color same with this background. So go to this fill and stroke, choose this linear gradient, and in this menu you can see the gradient history that you made before. So just click this, change the direction, go to this gradient and drag it. Okay, let's add some stroke in this shape. Okay, click it and go to this, right click, choose white. Okay, go to the stroke style, I change it into the pixel, change the width to 17, so it's thicker. Okay, now let's make some shadow below the shape. Click it and press Ctrl D, change the color into black and just inset the stroke. Right click, press remove stroke and move it down a little. Okay, place it below the shape. So click this lower selection one step. Alright, go to fill and stroke and choose this fill tab, increase the blur, decrease the opacity. Okay, really nice. Okay, now let's add some text. Go to this text tool and click on this and type and make it align to center and scale it up by pressing Ctrl Shift to make it proportional. Exchange the font into Bebas. This font is free for personal use and commercial use thanks to the creator. You can download the font in the link description below. Alright. Okay. And change it into this bold. And let's make some letter space to here and put some number to this box. I make it 10 and change the color into right click, just white. Okay, let's scale it up. Okay, now let's add some fleet style below the shape, or press B on your keyboard to activate the Bezier tool and draw some foot style, click it and click on here and click again and here to the end. Alright, okay, let's select this and go to this linear gradient, choose the gradient color that you made before. Okay, let's remove the stroke, right click, just remove and place it below this shape. Okay, let's add some shadow below this shape, click this shape and press Ctrl D, change it into black and move it here a little. So send it back to the lower, go to this fill tab and increase the blur, decrease the opacity. Okay, move it a little. Okay, let's add two more to this and this. Okay, now let's make some line particles. Press B on your keyboard or press the Bezier tool icon. Okay. And change the stroke into white, right click. Just click white. And go to fill and stroke. Go to the stroke style tab. Change it into 10 pixels. And make it rounded. Just click this round cap. Now let's double click and rotate it by pressing Ctrl Shift to make it 15 degrees. Okay, now let's change the length by pressing F2 on keyboard or this edit mode and press the Ctrl Alt on your keyboard so it keeps the angle. Alright. And next, let's duplicate more line, press Ctrl D and go to edit mode by pressing F2 and increase the length by pressing Ctrl Alt to keep the angle. Okay, repeat the step with another line. Okay, now let's make some dirt particles. Just click this circle and press Ctrl Shift to make it proportional. Just make it tiny. Okay. And then go to Path, Object to Path, so the circle is now editable. Right? Press Ctrl D to duplicate and move it here. Okay, select these two. Go to this extension, Inner From Path. Just interpolate and make sure you active this live preview. Make some good space. Okay, I think it's good. just click apply and close and move it down. Just delete these two. Okay, now let's make some rectangle shape with these dots. So go to this object, just transform. Okay, now let's input some numbers. I choose 20. And here's the trick. Before you click apply, press Ctrl D on your keyboard, then click apply. Press Ctrl D and click apply. Okay, repeat the step until it's rectangle shape. Alright, let's select this all and press Ctrl G to group. Okay, let's move it into here and change the color into white. And let's move this line particles. Okay, now let's duplicate. Let's Ctrl D and move it into back. Place it here and move this line here. Okay, the last thing is create some triangle particles. Just click this star icon and make sure the corner is 3 and drag it. Change the color into this red. Let's rotate and place it here. And duplicate one more and place it here. Change the color into yellow. Duplicate and place it here and rotate. That's it. I hope you enjoy and can learn how to make some modern background design in Inkscape. If you are working on stock images, this might be helpful how to create modern background design. Thanks for watching. Create something good today.